I have at the beginning a great great greeting from our Prime Minister of Slovak Republic. Yesterday I have meeting with our Prime Minister, and I informed him Slovak Anti-Poverty Network tomorrow will have a Zoom conference. So he sent many greetings, but today he is in Ukraine, so he couldn't participate, but next time. So we will, our Slovak Anti-Poverty Network and non-governmental organizations, they will be under government. So it is good news that we can better cooperate and participate in many projects. So first question is to all of you, that I would like to know, how is situation in your country with COVID, but also privately, yourself and your town, your state, your country? And second question is that how is in your country or your society with you online communication? Because 24th, 25th November, you can put this date to your calendar, will be European Anti-Poverty Network Zoom conference.
Jakob, podpredseda, som sa tak trocha do toho angažoval, veď ty vieš sama. A už počas toho, ako začal COVID, tak asi pol roka to už rozdávame každý mesiac.
Veľmi dobre. So he would like to describe that the whole Roma community is very thankful for food help, because every month they receive vitamins and such kind of food who is surviving. For example, rice and other flour and for bread and all kind of food. So every month this group, this community receive, and they are very thankful.
Slovenskej republiky, prezidenta Slovenskej republiky, pani Čaputovú a jej organizačný tým.
So second, beside this food help, they organized for all community, especially family with many children and poor families, the poorest families. Also this disinfection and this mask that every person has this mask, because that time it was 3-5 euro per one piece, and it was not too much quality. So he wrote to Office of President of Slovak Republic, Čaputová Zuzana, and he wrote also to state authorities, municipalities, to help to arrange for all this disinfection and hygiene and this mask. So is for every group, it is very good such steps to do. And when we do good things and good karmas for others, it is the best immune system.
Vrátim sa k vzdelávaniu detí, ktoré navštevujú základnú školu, takže školu povinné deti.
It was about distant education, because Roma children received, thanks to Vladko and his effort, from Orange Mobile Corporation cards to mobile handy, and they put it in handy, and children could teach and learn and communicate through parents' handy, parents' mobile telephone, and they could learn better, because majority children has no computer and no possibility distant learning. Dobre, Vladko?
Dobre, ďakujem. Veľmi sme nadviazali spoluprácu s ministerstvom zdravotníctva.
What is great problem in a Roma community that they read in this YouTube and all these Facebooks such informations, these hoax, about against vaccination. So they are not willing this Roma people vaccinate, and they are very now, because Vladko also breached cooperation with Ministry of Health. So he informed them from the beginning of COVID, how many people infected in their community, how many people abroad, who is coming from abroad and brought this illness and so on, this infection. So he gave good informations, and now they translated brochures with in Roma language that people should go for vaccination. They are now preparing already. Now is very good situation in Slovakia, but forecasting that come new wave of COVID. So they are now preparing all, team. Now I would like ask Lubka. Lubka is psychologist in another region.
No, ja by som tak v rýchlosti povedala, že asi pred rokom som bola na operácii.
Her personal situation, though she is a high educated person, as I told, psychologist, she lost a job, and since January she is without the job. Why? Because she passed through surgery, this knee, but this surgery doesn't work to good worse, so her knee is not good and painful. So when health is not good, job, there is no job. So such situation, but she is very happy that whole family was not infected by COVID. So she's very happy. Chief of our expert group is Elenka Novotná. Her opinion and her expertise.
Proste k kľúčom k riešenia problému bezdomovstva je v podstate komplexný prístup.
Then we would like to solve homeless people problem, we should be approaching complex, holistic approach. So she explained what it means, holistic approach, that we should solve it on all kind of levels, social level, political level, law, and physical level, material level, all kind of levels. So she will now explain how social approach, how our municipality, our state help socially help with minimum income to people in poverty, homeless people. So everybody receive minimum income in our country.
Čiže podľa ústavy.
So after our law and European law, every person Euro who is in Europe living, Europe inhabitant, should have such kind of help, social approach, minimum income approach, that should have money for one food daily, warm food, for textile and clothes, and for home. It means some room, some. So there is also another help. For example, when you lose your passport, your identity card, or you lose your room, your shelter, your house or housing, so you can receive help that you can arrange new passport, new room and so on.
Druhý bod, sociálna pomoc poskytovaná z hľadiska verejnej správy.
So you can arrange all this help, social help in municipality from state governmental help, and towns and municipalities have some law and they should help you. It is after our law. There is also possibility to give one time also financial help, but how much and who will from all kind of people receive, poor people receive this help, it depends on these towns, mayor of these towns and these municipalities and these villages.
Mesta majú vypracovaný komunitný plán.
There is also network of terrain work, and terrain social workers. And this kind of people help you. For example, they meet poor people and or poor person and bring it to doctor, to the social insurance company, and all kind of this kind of duties should be done. So and such person should write some documents, some papers, so they help to these people to write it and receive all this help. There is this kind of help is also possible, not only be given by state authorities and state institutions, but also given by NGOs, non-governmental organizations. So no government organizations after our European and Slovak law can also provide social consultation, social work, social help. And it is under this law, and they can also replace state authority. I know our law is like this, that first should help non-governmental organization, then should help family members, and last is state after our law. In her town, Topolčany, it is in the western part of Slovakia, there is such a plan, active plan, action plan prepared and functioning. And very active is her charity, Zdenka. And during this charity, this we can tell church organization, there is twice daily, weekly, Tuesday and Thursday, given bread, because there is in Topolčany very good and big, factory where is bread preparing. And they prepare many breads, and some of breads are given Tuesday and Thursday to the poorest people gratis. And it is bread of love. On website is new help for poor people since 1st May this year, bigger, much more money for help. So who will look for our for this website of Ministry of Social Affairs, social help can find all these details, information. So I would like to contact Jasbir.
Okay, namaste, dobre den to all. It was very serious. Actually, this was a sudden attack of corona wave, second corona wave they call. I think no government can be prepared for such a big attack. There were every day more than 30,000 cases in Delhi itself. So all over India, there were more than 4 lakh cases of COVID patients. And nobody can build so many hospitals and everything. So nobody can provide anything. So definitely it was a very serious emergency. And many people died. Many people died. In the first 2 weeks, yes, we were always afraid when the telephone bell was ringing. You know, it was always that the now news will be someone known is no more. It was happening like that. Every day, we were losing somebody known. And the media showed it in a very negative way. It was definitely a very bad situation, but it was not that bad how much it was shown on the television. You know, you just imagine in a normal routine, in a hospital, if there can be 200 patients, every day there were 25,000, 30,000 patients. So how hospitals can take? No hospital can provide bed. No hospital can provide oxygen. So government of India had to send emergency requests to almost 62 countries from where they received oxygen concentrators, cylinders and everything. And we at our own level, we requested, I requested to all my friends in Europe and other that if they can send, they can donate some oxygen concentrators so that we can help the people here on our own. And we did it. We received 3 concentrators, oxygen concentrators, and we donated it to the one of the Gurdwara, the Sikh temple here in my vicinity. where they were treating the people of the neighborhood because everybody cannot rush to. And every day we were receiving calls, just be help me, we are in emergency, we don't get hospital, we are not getting medicines. And we tried to put our friends in hospital as far as till Chandigarh, 250 kilometers from Delhi, because in Delhi there was no bed available. There were not such sort of things. And then, yes, the media was showing like India is the only place where COVID has happened. The Western media, the American media, they forgot last year when there were dead bodies on the streets in every part of the Europe, you know. But no, they were only showing that in India, the people are dying like they're going on the street, which was completely negative and very bad. Everybody got concerned about how India is going to survive, how it is happening. Yes. But you see, within three weeks, everything seems to be normal now here. The number of cases per day in New Delhi, in the capital, is now less than 1,000, which was 30,000 at the beginning of the month. So within 3 weeks, it is now less than 1,000. The hospital beds are vacant. Anybody, means every hospital where there were 500 beds, now more than 300 beds are available. So the situation is very much under control, and the responsibility for such situation cannot be solely put on the governments. It was on the people. They all started thinking like they are God. Corona cannot hit them. They were going on the streets like mad people. They were without masks. They were, I tell you, there were some recent festivals in India. And I went to market to buy sweets. On the sweet shop, the people were like jumping on one another, you see. And nobody was taking any caution that the corona is still in India. And the behavior of people was really, really very irresponsible. And we helped at our personal level. You see, we were trying to arrange food for the poor people. We were trying to arrange for the needy oxygen cylinders. We were trying to arrange for them the medicines, those. So it was only a network, because it's a complete lockdown. We cannot go out of the home. So it was all on the telephone. You see, whole of the day, we were connecting from one place to other, to one person to other, and trying to help if from somewhere the help can come. Yes, we could help a lot of people, but we could not help a lot also, because the pandemic attack was so huge that if there was, like last year, the attack was not that severe. If somebody was affected in one family, there was not necessary that second will be also affected. But now what happened this time? If one member in the family got affected, the whole family got ill because of the COVID. And it was very difficult for them to even, and then within 3 days, this attack of COVID, within 3 days, it was affecting the lungs. And you got the breathlessness, and there was nothing that you need, only oxygen, continuous supply of oxygen.
Now, our friend from India, Pravin.
First, namaste to all friends here. And thanks, Slovak Anti-Poverty Network, that given me opportunity to express my things here. So first thing is that, according to the education system is gradually getting decreasing day by day. First thing is that the poor people has not mobile, no internet connection in the villages. So they cannot get proper education. Only the rich people has a fast network service, mobile and laptops. So now the education is only for rich people. The online lectures is not a successful way for the, I think in India, it's not a success. Out of country, I don't know about the other countries, but in India, every places we cannot spread knowledge. First thing is that. And second thing is that due to corona, just I am seeing day by day, many parents are dying. In one of my students, first, her father, one girl, her father got corona positive. After some time, he died. And after 15 or 20 days, her mother got COVID positive. And she died too. So now only one girl in his family, her family. So now the situation is what to do with her. There is no parents. There is no other family members. So this is the very, very bad situation for this type of families. And I think in India, I know the all over country, I think all countries are getting this problem. But in India, I think this is a very big problem to handle, because the reason is we have a big population. First thing is that 135 crores. So this is the big population. So we cannot handle it. 70% of Indians, I think, that lost their jobs. First thing. And just suppose me, I am teacher and I am getting fees from the buddies. They have lost their jobs. They are not paying me. Then how can I accommodate myself? So this is the circle. This is the chain. Then all are getting suffered. Not only me. All are getting suffered. I cannot ask to anybody. They cannot ask to company, because already they lost. Who have not lost their jobs? They are getting less salary. They have a car loan. They have home loan. They have accommodation and all over the things in this situation. No bank is stopping now. Last year, the all buddies, I think, got some EMI moratorium, EMI holidays. It means you will not pay for 3-4 months EMI. This is the rule by RBI, Reserve Bank of India. But now wave two, there is no system for EMI loans. I think for teachers, government should be take one proper step for that. Because we teachers are getting lots of problems, many problems, because we cannot teach properly in this situation, and we are not getting salary. I am also out of job from last 1 year because of the COVID. Before the 1 year, I was good. So not only me, like many teachers are getting lots of problems due to Corona, because we have no place to move. India helped many countries, but in this situation, India needs some help.
And also cleaners who clean, all these garbage people who clean from garbage. These kind of people, the smallest salary, they are the most important first line people.
Only one thing I want to say, I want to announce that for Slovak anti-poverty, what is this?
Network.
If you are having in your network the poor students who can speak English, who can understand English, I can provide free education, free mathematics for them. I will not take charge for that. If you will get any student for that, just contact to me. I will teach mathematics and English free of cost. I will not take any cost for that.
Housing. She received from our state her first apartment. And we are very happy that she has new apartment in our capital, in very good situation with nice view. So soon I will go to her, because was lockdown and no traveling, but we are happy she invited us to her house, and we will enjoy best party with this house. So she will tell us some vote for Slovak people.
Dobrý deň. Podvečer, večer.
So it began 2001. I was, as Anna described me, 2001, very bad situation. And I was walking during Bratislava Street, in Bratislava Street, and there was some posture that with Picasso, but also was some article, some posture, that we would like ask people who will sell Nota Bene magazine for homeless people, for poor people. So we invite them, such kind of people, and they can sell Nota Bene and receive small money from our society. And she was coming to this meeting, and she tell, I am prepared to sell Nota Bene. And she received, that time was a new magazine, a first magazine, and she received number 001 it is that she is first seller of Nota Bene in Czech, in Slovakia. Since January, she received some four half-day job daily, helping wheelchair person, ill person. So 4 hours daily, she helped him and received some money. During COVID, no more selling this magazine, Nota Bene. So they gave her some food and something, some support. And so such is situation. I can only add that she is much more better than, for example, Pravin in India, though he's a healthy teacher. So I am very thankful to all of you. And maybe it's time to finish, Ano, and looking forward to meet you again. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Thank you very much.
Bye-bye. 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 Bye-bye.